Much has been made about race in this case. Where do you see race in this case?
I see race being injected into this case in the first week that it existed. And I see that it's never left this case, even though time and time and time again, race has been proven not to have been an element in George's consideration at that night. I see attorneys who say 4 weeks ago that this is the most significant civil rights trial of the century. And then I see a partner of his a week ago saying race has nothing to do with this case. So I only wish that they would have said race has nothing to do with this case in, let's say, March 15th. Or March 16th, which was the day that they heard the tape. Anytime before they allowed the pressures and the animosities to foment to the point where there was at least concerns over civil unrest, disobedience, riots, whatever you want to call it.
This case, to many, is a cause. It's not just a case. These would be people who are very much in support of Trayvon Martin, who believe that there was great wrong here. And in essence, that this is a civil rights case. And I mean that in the full sense of advancing civil rights. You are perceived as the man standing in the way of this civil rights case.
Right.
How do you handle that?
Very simply, I will walk over to that side, put my arm around those people, and walk with them on a civil rights issue. I've represented young black males for 30 years. I know better than most people, better than most of the people who are complaining, how young black males are treated in the criminal justice system. And we need to fix it. We need to address those problems. It's not just in the system, it's in the schools, it's in the churches, it's in the families, it's in the homes. We need to address it. Get your crosshairs off George Zimmerman and I will join you. Keep your crosshairs on George Zimmerman and don't tell me that I'm getting in the way, because you are. Because you're the one who's sitting back telling me that this is a civil rights case when George had nothing to do with civil rights. This was an unfortunate event between two people. I want to walk down that path. I want to have a conversation. I've been asking for that conversation for over a year. Let's talk about it. This is a great opportunity for that conversation. Even if we didn't do it right, even if George Zimmerman was not the poster child for racial improprieties towards young black males, now that the conversation has raced to the forefront, let's have it. But don't let that conversation override Mr. Zimmerman's rights to a fair trial. He's just not the racist you thought he was. And my fear is that now that they've connected that conversation to his conviction, that his acquittal is going to be seen as a negative for civil rights. Absolutely untrue.